Well, hello folks, and welcome back. Friday. Friday's supposed to be easy, right? Yeah, right. Not in construction. So what we got going on? All right, so we're really putting the old rammer to the test today. 2017 Ram 3500 high output, 295, 65, 20 tires on it. So we're running like 35, 35.2 is what they work out to be. Toyo Open Country AT3, so you know, not standard size, not standard tire, pretty aggressive tire. I'm not sitting on flat ground right now, so you can see the trailer. It's got a pretty good negative rake to it, but I do think that it is still a little bit high. I've got just a regular 21,000 pound rated, just normal hitch. I don't have the Gen Y hitch today. And we've got a 2022 New Holland C345 and the brand new Osma SSQ 180 mulcher, which I have not used yet. Basically have just played around with it here for a few minutes. This has the variable speed motor in it, so I had to tune it. I'm gonna make a separate video on all this, on the first use of the mulcher, so this is just towing. So the skid steer is like almost 11,000 pounds. The mulcher is almost 4,000 pounds. Right around there, like 3,500, 4,000. So we're getting close to 15 right there. The trailer, I honestly have no idea how much it weighs. I'm guessing like 4,000 to 5,000 pounds. Anyway, we're creeping close to 20 behind the truck. I believe, yeah, we should be right around that, I think. Close to 20, maybe less, like 18. We'll call it 18, just because people are gonna beat me up in the comment section. But anyway, we're gonna see how this thing does. I've got a pretty good drive. We're just outside Bridgewater, and we're heading down to Sable River. So we got a pretty decent trip. Not a lot of hills on that section of highway, but there is still a few hills. This is the heaviest load I've hauled with this truck so far. So I've hauled the skid steer with it, with the bucket on it, but I have not hauled it with the mulcher on it. I think the day that I hauled my mulcher to the hydraulic shop to get the fittings swapped around and matched up, I had my 350, my Ford, and it did good. So, I mean, I think this is gonna do good. It's gonna definitely lack a little bit of power because of the bigger tires and stuff, but the braking, the engine braking, the factory airbags on this thing really make it nice to haul with. You can see that they've got the air into them. They're ready to roll. So, all right, let's see what this thing does. All right, so I need all the extra help I can get, all the horsepower. So I got the mirrors up, gain that extra bit of horsepower. Got my exhaust brake on, obviously. And tow haul. We're ready to rock. All right, here we go. I'm not gonna put my foot right into it, just kind of doing its thing. First time, like I said, hauling with this load, so you know, also finding this sweet spot on the trailer might take a little bit of time, but right now it feels pretty good. I'm up to speed anyway, so that was pretty uneventful. Yeah, well, that was nothing at all. All right, so right now it feels absolutely awesome, so stable. Like I've said before, airbags are awesome when you're hauling weights in this thing. We got our first hill coming up here. It's down to third. Or fourth. Fourth. This fourth gear held its load on this hill. Not a big one, but it's the first hill that we had. Yeah, I definitely got to get some airbags on that 350 so I can really do a accurate comparison of the two side by side. Because as far as power goes, especially now with the exhaust, the muffler delete that I did to the 350, I mean, that thing's working good. But stability wise, this is better. But yeah, I definitely need to get some airbags on that 350 and then I can do a comparison. Because they're both, like, this is a 2017, that's a 2018 or 2019, but it's like before Ford went to the 10 speed. So it's their like previous engine sort of, and then it's their previous transmission. So these ones are like matched up really close. Both trucks got 35s on them, you know, all that sort of stuff. So it'd be a pretty darn good comparison, that's for sure. But yeah, so far this thing is, I can't say it's, you know, it's impressing me because it's just doing what I figured it would do. But I got a car in front of me that's going a little slower than what I want to go. So it has passing power. So that's a check mark. Going down a pretty good grade right now. The engine brake is really working. But I'm about 10 kilometers an hour over what I set my speed to. And it won't downshift. Or it didn't downshift. Like, I haven't hauled enough weight with this truck yet, going down steep enough hills to be able to tell if this one is like my dually. My 17 dually, like, I haul 30,000 pounds around with that on a daily basis. That thing will not downshift in cruise control. Unless I put my foot on the brake, it will not downshift. Whereas the Fords would always, in cruise control, they'll always downshift. They're always gonna try their best to keep you in that, at that speed. The Ram will use the exhaust brake, but it won't downshift. And people were, in my videos before, people were like, you gotta get that checked out. It could be something with your tuning, or, you know, whatever, because that was my first Ram, my first Cummins. But this is the second one, and from my experience so far, this one is the same thing. It just won't downshift going down hills. So guys out there, like, you know, especially PD diesel power. I mean, that'd be the guy to talk to. He's had so many of these Rams, especially the fourth gens. You know, do you actually have to tap the brake in order to get the thing to downshift, or like, what's the scenario here? But man, this thing in fourth gear at like 2200 RPM, she pulls strong. It skips fifth pretty much all together. Every hill that I hit, it just goes from sixth to fourth, just bang, and it's smooth. It's a good quick smooth but solid shift. Could easily just cancel out sixth gear, and probably long term that's what I'll do, because even at 105 kilometers an hour, which is like 63 miles per hour, which is a good speed for hauling this weight, I'm still only at like 1700 RPM. So sixth gear really isn't needed, to be honest. But the shift from sixth to fourth is really smooth as it is. If I was on flat ground the whole time, maybe keep six. But there's very few spots in Nova Scotia that is flat. It's like, this is mild, but it's still up and down. The whole time is up and down. But there's spots in Nova Scotia that are way, 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 way worse than this. So we've got a really good gradual downhill here, and then once it crests, it gets steeper. Now I'm in sixth gear right now. Now let's just see. I'm not gonna let this thing get out of control. Let's just see what the speed could potentially get up to before I have to tap the brake. I'm pretty sure there's a sharp turn right up here. Once I come down over this hill, I think there's a sharp turn going that way, so I'm not gonna let this thing start getting away on me, that's for sure. But it did just drop to fifth right there. So yeah, I mean, honestly, sixth gear is really not needed. And for you guys that have used these trucks for a long time, you probably, the second that you hook up to a trailer, you probably just cancel sixth gear altogether and just use the five. Yeah, and this isn't the hill that I was thinking of, actually. But this is probably, this could be like the toughest hill climb so far, I would say. I mean, I don't have a percentage for grade on this thing, but we're in fifth right now. Fourth. Definitely one thing about it is these Rams are a lot louder than the Fords. Like right out of factory, this thing's got some noise to it. So we are losing a bit of speed. We're down to basically right at 100. Still in fourth gear. Now we're climbing. So would this truck have held its speed with the factory size tires on it? In fourth, there's a very good chance that it would have. So it definitely seems just like my dually, that it will not downshift. And one thing with the Fords, I don't know if it was in only adaptive cruise, because I really only noticed it with my 450, and that had the adaptive cruise control, which I used all the time. When I'd be hauling my gooseneck, especially at nighttime, you could really notice it. Going down hills, it downshifts, yes, but it also applies the brakes and the trailer brakes. Because I could see the reflection of my brake lights on the trailer. And this is definitely not doing any of that. It's more driver controlled. Absolutely. This truck doesn't have the technology. Maybe the fifth gens do. I haven't hauled with a fifth gen, to be honest. So maybe the fifth gens do. Use the trailer brake and downshift and all that sort of stuff. But these fourth gens, they're still very, very much operator, like, controlled. That's not a bad thing at all, because a lot of guys don't even like using cruise control when you're towing. But with the new vehicles, the way they have them set up now, especially with the adaptive cruise and the trailers they're making now with the brakes that are so strong, I'm telling you guys, like, it's not like the old days, especially with the stick shift, where you have to be right on top of things. The truck really does a lot for you, like a lot. One thing about it though, I can tell you, when you put your foot on the brake on this thing and she downshifts, especially with the engine brake, the exhaust brake, it really slows you down a heck of a lot better than the Fords do, that's for sure. We got the steepest pull coming up here around this turn in Granite Village. Anyone watching the videos that knows the area, especially truckers and stuff, you know that this is a tough one, because you can't get a whole lot of speed built up before you get into all this hill, because there's just turn after turn after turn. So right now it's in fifth. I'm just gonna let it do its thing. Just drop to fourth, down to third. Oh, should never have dropped back down to fourth. Back up to third again. Yeah, I don't know why it's doing that. It's never done this before. Now it figured it out.
Third gear's got lots of power. It's speeding up now. Yeah, I never did that before. It just must not have been steep enough that it was just in between those gears. And obviously, that is the big selling feature and the beauty of the higher gear transmissions is that there's always a gear that these things like. With six gears, you know, the gears are further apart, especially with the 342 rear end. I don't think any of these trucks should ever come out of the dealership with a 342. Especially, you know, a Cummins, a Ram truck is known for hauling weights. They went to a 342 for fuel mileage, but guys buy these trucks typically to tow camper trailers, equipment, you know, all that sort of stuff. 373 with a 6-speed transmission is what you'd want in these trucks. My 350 has a 355 and it does pretty good, but it would be even better with a 373.
All right, well, here we are. So typically, I would obviously back into these locations, but we're on the Trans-Canada Highway and it's busy. So I got off the shoulder all the way off. Thankfully, it's a nice wide shoulder and I took 5 minutes to clear up enough here that I could get the truck off the road. But yeah. Separate video, stay tuned. First time using the mulcher, and you see what we got to work with here. You think it's slightly grown in? Anyway, let's put this thing to work. I'm gonna do as much as I can do with the skid steer. I'm probably gonna have to potentially still bring the excavator in to get the shoulders, and some of these ditches are pretty wet, but this thing is so much faster than the excavator that I can come in here for a few hours and really open it up, and then the excavator can just come in and kind of clean things up. But anyway, we'll see what this looks like at the end of the day. Well, how's that? I'd say that's pretty good. Anyone who drove by this place and seen this place this morning, then came in here and seen it right now, you'd be like, what the heck happened there today? Yeah, she's opened up, she's looking good. The anchors. Alright folks, well there it is. She's back and it's perched. Well, not really, but that's where it is for now. It did absolutely phenomenal. So there's a few things where it could do better at, and I'm sure the fifth gens now, they downshift with the cruise control and all that sort of stuff, but as far as actually controlling the load, the Rams are, my personal experience, like the Fords do good, they do really good, but the Rams just have that next small level of comfort feel, I guess, when you're hauling the heavier loads. With this one being a single rear wheel, the dually feels really good too. Obviously my 550 did, my 450 felt great, but yeah, I don't know, it did good. So the first time towing with the skid steer and the mulcher, which is gonna be the setup, this is what I sold the 450 and bought this to haul this setup. This is, it's a good feeling knowing that I didn't completely mess up. But anyway, folks, I hope you enjoyed the video. Have a great weekend if I get this up tonight. Take care, stay safe, and we'll see you then. Bye.